Hello and welcome everyone. This is Blackadder at Blackadder's Place. I welcome you to today's stream. Well, it's gonna be quite a bit earlier today, as you can tell. And hopefully it's gonna be working out as well, because they are both Australians or Australians. Berserker is Canadian, but currently he's residing in Australia. And that means that, at least I know, think that he's still in Australia somewhere, that they are quite a bit world apart. At least from me, so hopefully it's not gonna be causing too much of a bad luck for them, because if it were, then obviously not gonna be ready to step aside. As if they are right next to each other in the world, then obviously no reason to be introducing the luck to them, but hopefully it's gonna be fine. As you can already have seen, some Australian realities, actually some magpies attacking Berserker when he was biking, and all kinds of funny stuff. Yeah, well, in Australia it seems like everything really wants to kill you. But overall, we have apparently seen also agreement that they're gonna be playing effectively just the normal maps, not anything special. And they're gonna be banning there for... Originally, Ardeshir wanted to ban Vinland Saga, it seemed like, with Archipelago, rather that was actually Berserker. So Ardeshir is banning Anatolia and Watering Hole, okay. Yeah, kind of banning the water a bit. And, okay, Sanatoria. Yeah, so they are kind of agreeing a bit on the house rules here. It's a bit unclear if it's supposed to be best of three or five, actually. So they have banned Anatolia and Watering Hole here. Mediterranean, Anatolia. Okay, ban it. Oh, it seems like a Mediterranean Anatolia is therefore gonna be going off. That's what I can kind of glean from that, and from what we have seen there. So hopefully, everything is going at this point according to Aegis. Oh well, triple Zeus, of course. Gonna be adding the Zeus there, there as well. So gonna be adding Savannah, apparently. They chose the map, right? Because they are supposed to be choosing the maps. But nonetheless, haven't exactly noticed, but let's kind of engage in the game itself at this point, and hey Prowler and everybody else who's going to be potentially joining at this quite a bit early hour, especially for my stream. But yeah, well, hopefully going to be having some good Age of Mythology fun as well, as we certainly do have the quality rate about now promised in Berserker, and well, Ardeshir as well. We have seen some cool game, the first round that he was playing, that was... Oh man, if only I could actually remember who he was playing against. I mean, like, we do have bracket in the... potentially in the chat. I don't think I actually edited it into title, or did I? Actually, I did, okay. So no problem with that. That is actually all covered. That is actually all covered. But nonetheless, let's look around the map here a bit, then I potentially can be delving into the bracket. Again, as you do have Eye of Ornu as one of the relics here right now available for the game. You can see right now the TC is gonna be quite a bit further in the corner. You can see also excellent, rather food source. I mean, like, seriously excellent. This is like a double herd, maybe even triple. I mean, like, wow. Original maps, right? 9 and for 13 giraffes. And giraffe is a 300 foot, so this is almost 4,000 foot. If you're gonna be counting the hyenas, this is more than 4,000 foot, 4,200. Seriously. Seriously, seriously, quite a great spot on the map. No, well, and obviously the starting gold is also not entirely too terrible. Seems like a pretty good spot. And then we're all the way to the right side. That's gonna be Berserker starting with the gold, maybe a bit forward. You can see a bit further away from the towers, but nonetheless, he does a wood line here. You can see he's already working towards hauling it off. So he certainly does have quite a clear idea about what to potentially do here. He's gonna be also having TC in the corner with tons of hunt. Just so far, it seems like it's not gonna be maybe all the herds together, as we have seen for Ardeshir. This is gonna be apparently only the big one. 4 or 5, yeah, that's the double. And that's the third one, therefore. So this one is an extra. Those giraffes. Double Elise. That's gonna be right now lone giraffe to the left side. What? That's... two lone giraffes. No, we're still gonna be having, at this point, to kind of wait for a bit more exploration, because sometimes on original maps, obviously, you don't have to be having the whole herd actually spawned. As the constraints there are a bit more funnier, so yeah, kind of slightly depends actually what's going to happen with that and how it's gonna be appropriately or inappropriately spawning Pelt of Argus is really awesome. It's gonna be helpful in the raiding. As I'm also slightly curious about what's going to happen as far as the strategies. We have, for example, seen even on Vanilla San Kentau raiding. Even though it's harder, it's certainly not impossible. Certainly not impossible at all. And now we're just gonna look in also at the distribution of the gold and especially the front TCs. As it seems like that Berserker is gonna be having both of them at one spot, which doesn't have to be too great considering there is no gold mine kind of like covered here. This one is gonna be the closest, which is not too terrible, frankly. Can be though a bit better, like for example what we have seen for Ardeshir here to the top side. Yeah, he's gonna be having TC on each side of his base. So this is a quite nice combo, same as well the one to the bottom that we have already shown. I mean, like, really the map for Ardeshir is not really too terrible at all. Kinda liking it. Kinda liking his map quite a bit, as he's gonna be already dropping a temple. For Berserker, trying to probably advance, you had about 4 minutes of the game time. So yeah, I think it's gonna be making sense that he's gonna be coming through quite a bit soon. Okay, now it's gonna be therefore probably time to be having a look onto the bracket who actually Ardeshir beat in the first round. We have casted it last week, last Friday, or kind of like the week before, so 2 weeks at this point, effectively like 10 days or whatever along those lines you can be thinking about it. Okay, there is the bracket. You can also get it exclamation mark bracket into the chat if you wish. And he was playing with Rappel, of course. So yeah, that was a fun match. And by the way, there's gonna be, when we're talking about Rappel, there is actually going to be a match also later today between, start should be about between 13 and 14 GMT, between Shelty and Rappel exactly. So in about, 3 hours from now? Something like that. There's gonna be another match. That's obviously going to be streamed as well. I mean, like, I'm gonna be ready. So possibly it's going to be me. If there's gonna be somebody else showing up who wants to stream it, and possibly it's gonna be somebody else, I don't know, maybe Boyd is gonna be showing up, who knows, or Shadowfax. So there's gonna be possibility of that, but otherwise if not, then we're gonna be available and we're gonna be there for casting it here on the channel. That's another match from AOL Destroyers Vanilla Summer Tournament for the year 2021. For quite nice €300, so thank you very much for supplying the Vanilla community with such fun tournaments, Destroyer. And hopefully, you're having some good fun with that as well. Okay, I'm just gonna be chasing each other right about now, the Kataskopai. So you're gonna be so far heading into, for Ardeshir. Did he already have the advance? He did, from Berserker. Bit curiously, he's gonna be going for Athena, so therefore, not curiously. Yet again, Kentau Raiden is not entirely all that much of a necessary thing in Vanilla, because you don't get the free one at the start of Classical Age. And at the same time, you are also having to pay a bit higher amount of favor for the Kentaur. On Titans he's 12, right? And here's 15. Because in Vanilla everything is a bit more expensive. So he's gonna be picking up the relic that was the one. I don't exactly remember what it was. The Eye of Ornlu, or it was for the other small improvements in 3 units. As there gonna be way too many villages, so therefore Yason won't be exactly too having too many high chances to actually get some kind of kill here. But nonetheless, still, Ardeshir also doesn't have to be sending too many villages against him, just basically here and there, one or two, to push him away. But with all the Odysseus in, that's a whole different story, and it might be actually becoming quite a bit more complicated. Should be probably bolt in the Odysseus. Yeah, I think he should be really bolting him, right now it's gonna be rather running away, which is quite a bit of a problem, because that's a quite nice bountiful field for food. You can see he's gonna be advancing at 6.5 minutes, as that's definitely not the earliest, as he does have also the Rhinos to the right side, which potentially could be helping him out, and we do see some other giraffes therefore or not. No, they are the Eli, so it really seems to me that the giraffes, okay, there is actually a group of giraffes. So is that both spawning for Ardeshir, even the hunt that was supposed to be Berserkers? Kind of thinking so. Thinking it might be the case. And hey, Harry. Yeah, well, all is fine here. Earlier stream today, definitely quite a bit earlier than normal. No, and we are going to be at this point looking at Ardeshir, of course, having a bit of a hard time at the defense with the ball there. Kind of, why not? Because Berserker obviously doesn't need to be worried about any kind of other units, and for example, about heroes, about potentially Odysseus from Ardeshir coming up. He's not gonna be really targeting all that many of his units. So I think this is gonna be quite a bit fine with ceasefire coming forward, which a bit unfortunate. Probably could have been casted quite a bit early on the food so that he can stay there. Thinking it would have been a bit more reliable and better option overall for him. Corbeck, thank you very much for the flow. As well, also the wood line is quite a bit sucky at this point for Ardeshir. This is usually kind of like the nightmare for Greek. You don't want that because you're gonna be having to pay a lot for storehouses. So it's effectively a waste of resources. As the next ones are quite a bit far away, out of reach of any kind of reasonable protection. And we already do have medium hippicons, so in about 20 seconds, even though he has returned back quite nicely, it is going to be a problem. And would it be nice if we were in Titans, right? Because he would be able to take the TC, which would give him a lot of food. It would be giving him right now the large gold mine. He would be also getting some woodline, berries. I mean, like, it would have been absolutely dream come true. But since you are in vanilla, that is not the case. And therefore, as he's trying to, oh, quite nicely play a berserker. Exactly in the middle of the release. Blocking the path in. Gonna be probably killing like one or two, maybe. Okay, this one actually coming back. She was trying to maybe avenge her friends here in the battle. But nonetheless, you can see both restoration, all kinds of good powers coming forward. It's gonna be resulting into quite a bit of a massacre. And even though we do have at least a few hoplites here, I'm not entirely all that convinced we have plenty of them, or rather enough of them. Also getting plenty of favor. Seems like that he's gonna be wanting to get potentially a bit of centaurs, but I'm thinking it's gonna be a bit too slow, and yep, that's gonna be a GG already called. So, let's resign with them, and it's gonna be the first one therefore, with Berserker getting a victory. And quite a clean one here on Savannah, so a good performance by him. And I also need to be switching into Titans, I just right now noticed on my overlay, so sorry for that, as we are mystifying that we are actually on Titans, but we are not. But nonetheless, in the first round of the losers bracket, it's going to be Berserk right now leading Ardeshir 1-0, and it's not entirely all that clear, to be honest, if it's supposed to be best of 5 or 3, because the original rules with the first round being best of 3 and everything else best of 5, besides finals and semis, being best of 7 have been made for single elimination before it changed. So yeah, I think they aggregate into 5, so you're going to be seeing 3 different maps, or at least should be. And, well, we are as usual on 2-minute delay, as is normal, on competitive games, so sorry if I'm not gonna be potentially answering in time, but yeah, well, it's of course important for the competitive integrity of the players, even though I'm kinda thinking that maybe they wouldn't be minding playing without it anyway, but don't want to be even putting them into the choice currently, not much of a reason for that. Can see right now in the statistics, you're gonna be seeing quite a bit of an edge for Berserker. Yeah, he's an experienced player, and by the way, if maybe somebody is finding Ardeshir's name a bit familiar, then it might be because he is actually a streamer for Age of Mythology Online, or the Age of Mythology, sorry, Age of Empires Online. So yeah, for Project Celeste. So that's maybe where you can be actually knowing him from. As it seems like you're gonna be BRBing for a moment for Ardeshir, so we do have a time to look right now through the statistics. You can see it now, 1200, 5, 17, so and 13, about 3000 resources more for Berserker in 3 minutes, or the, in 3 minutes, yeah, kind of 3 minutes of classical time, 3 to 4, let's say. That is, of course, a decent edge. Even though he wasn't having that many more villages, he's gonna be having more efficiency because he didn't have to be running away with the villages from the hunt. You can see right now Hendax and Pickaxe with Husbandry. And Husbandry here on the other side as well. So all kinds of resources nicely prepared. Base here already apparently getting ready for the Heroic Age with triple stable buildup. It's quite a bit. Considering he's not a posse, that's actually quite a few of them, but alright. Went rather well for him, didn't it? Yeah, well, unfortunately, seems like Ardeshir probably a bit fumbled the start and the hunt. Thinking he maybe didn't find it actually quickly enough. As he unfortunately cannot exactly appreciate the like scouting all that appropriately here. And he probably didn't even see the rhinos to the right side, I'm expecting. So that's why he was having a bit of a problem with later advance. Whereas the opponent did find the giraffes very quickly. Can see even build a second granary on it, which is kind of worthwhile. It was effectively double hunt, so why not? And the 7 hoplites. Couldn't be dealing with the 17 hippicons there. Kind of interesting right about now on the release. Because, no, not that rather. But the advance was quite a bit delayed, of course, so that's Ardeshir right now, even quite a bit higher up here. You can see that Berserker therefore wasn't making too many villages, no, sure, during the advance, but even before that he was waiting a bit. He's having a bit of a longer flat line here. For some time. Otherwise the number of the vills, yeah, kind of fairly similar. Maybe expecting that Berserker is gonna be a bit higher up there, but nonetheless he opted to be choosing, I think he also opted to be given a bit more into his normal villages, but nonetheless it's more likely going to be because of the hero production. We have seen that Ardeshir wasn't going for Odysseus either all that quickly, or even actually at all, so this is gonna be probably Odysseus here, and maybe that was actually even Jason before that. Yeah, it's gonna be probably the Jason here as well, maybe not even a village missing. Okay, nonetheless, GG.